This module will provide guidance to emergency departments for the development of hospital-specific plans and procedures to ensure the safety of staff, patients, and visitors, as well as to inform and coordinate with local health authorities.
Hi, can I help you?
I don't know what's wrong with me, but I really don't feel well.
If a patient reports recent travel to countries with widespread Ebola transmission or exposure to someone known to have Ebola virus disease, and also exhibits or reports symptoms consistent with Ebola, isolation precautions must be implemented and further evaluation should occur in a designated private room or separate enclosed area with private bathroom or covered bedside commode.
Could you follow me to this room, please? We're just going to put you here just temporarily. We're going to ask you a few more questions.
Adherence to procedures and precautions designed to prevent transmission by direct or indirect contact is vital. For patients under investigation for Ebola, hand hygiene, appropriate precautions, dedicated equipment, and restricted patient movement are important to protect other patients, visitors, and staff. Once notification is received that a patient under investigation for Ebola is identified, ensure the designated isolation room is prepared. If available, you may decide to put the patient in an isolation room with negative pressure in anticipation of needing to perform any aerosol-generating procedures. All unnecessary medical equipment should be removed from the room prior to the patient arriving. There should be separate areas adjacent to the isolation room to be used for donning and doffing PPE. Ensure all appropriate PPE is available, and staff have been trained to properly don and doff PPE. Post a Do Not Enter room sign on the door and a sign-in log on the door to document who enters the room. Consider providing a phone or call device so the clinical staff can communicate with the patient from outside the room to limit the number of staff who must enter the room and to limit potential exposure. When the isolation room is prepared, the triage or charge nurse will escort the patient to the isolation room, avoiding physical contact and keeping a distance of at least 3 feet from the patient.
You can just come this way, please.
Okay.
No PPE is required if the patient is able to ambulate to the isolation room in this way. While the patient is being escorted into the room and given instructions, the healthcare worker should be donning appropriate PPE. Please refer to the section of the CDC website illustrating procedures for proper donning and doffing of PPE. If the patient is not able to ambulate, the triage or charge nurse should don PPE to transport the patient to the isolation room. While escorting the patient to the isolation room, tell the patient the reason for the isolation precautions, what to expect, and assure them that someone will be in contact with them throughout the process. At this point, the patient will likely be concerned and unsure of what is happening around them, so it is important to communicate with them and let them know what to expect. If you choose to use a phone or other communication device, explain to the patient that someone will be speaking with them on the communication device in the room and asking them further questions about their symptoms and risk factors. As the patient is being isolated and further risk factors and symptoms are assessed by the healthcare team, activate your institution's Ebola preparedness plan and notify infection control or the appropriate designated staff. Notify your local public health authorities immediately that your facility is evaluating a patient with relevant travel and/or exposure history or symptoms that might be consistent with Ebola. To minimize transmission risk, only essential healthcare workers with designated roles should provide patient care. A log should be maintained of all personnel who enter the patient's room. All healthcare workers who have contact with the patient should put on appropriate PPE based on the patient's clinical status. If the patient is not exhibiting obvious vomiting, bleeding, or other discharge of bodily fluids, PPE recommended for patients without obvious vomiting, bleeding, or other discharge of bodily fluids should be used. If the patient is exhibiting obvious vomiting, bleeding, or other discharge of bodily fluids, then PPE recommended for hospitalized patients with Ebola should be used. Once the patient is safely isolated, continue the patient assessment. Obtain additional history, perform a physical examination, and provide medical care as necessary. Remember, most patients who are screened do not have Ebola. Ensure there is no delay in these patients' care by being prepared to evaluate, manage, and treat alternative etiologies of febrile illness as clinically indicated. Frontline hospitals will identify, isolate, stabilize, and notify the local public health authorities, and prepare to transfer the patient to an Ebola assessment hospital or treatment center. Ebola assessment hospitals will continue to care for the patient for up to 96 hours until the diagnosis is confirmed or ruled out. Each facility's role is to safely provide care for the patient and to inform the public health authorities, who will help to ensure that the patient can be evaluated safely and/or transferred to another type of facility as appropriate. In this module, we have provided guidance to emergency departments for the development of hospital-specific plans and procedures to ensure the safety of staff, patients, and visitors, as well as to inform and coordinate with local health authorities. Please continue with the next module, which outlines steps to evaluate and briefly manage patients under investigation for Ebola.